Hi, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. Welcome to our website. Yeah, I've got a great new Cougar fifth wheel to show you. This is a really nice floor plan. It's called a 283 RET. Again, it's brand new, 2017. Just got it in. You're going to like the way this is laid out, I believe. It's got a really good floor plan with three slide outs, so it gives you plenty of floor space, but it's still not a super long fifth wheel. So if you're looking for something that's a good balance between towability and livability, this could be a really good choice. Notice, speaking of towability, they designed the front cap here. This is a molded fiberglass front cap too, by the way. It's contoured to make it easier to maneuver if you get into some tight spots. You've got the cutaway here to help protect the back of your truck, so if you're making a tight turn, less chance that you're going to hit the front of your trailer to the back of your pickup truck. Notice too, it does have a nice hitch vision set up on this. The idea behind this is you could be looking in your rear view mirror as you're backing up and see the reflection of the hitch, so you can see where you're at in relation to your hitch in your truck and the hitch pin on the trailer. Even has a little light back in here. You got LED light strip in here as well. And then underneath here, you do have storage. This opens up into a nice little storage area where your batteries are going to be. We're going to make sure you have two batteries in it. It just has one battery box now, but you will have two brand new batteries and two battery boxes when you take it out of here. Nice solar panel set up in this, so it's plugged. Has a plug-in for a solar panel for a portable. Doesn't come with a solar panel, but it is wired for portable, so you could get one of those portable units, plug it in here, and have your a way to keep your batteries charged up if you like to dry camp a lot. Even has a little light in here and for when you're docking up front. The propane tanks are split, one on each side. The reason they do that is for good weight distribution, again for towability reasons. Has a nice pass-through storage area. I like those magnetic latches that keeps it right in place. Notice you got a huge compartment area, plenty of room to put your stuff when you're out on the road. This is a welded aluminum frame unit also, so it's built really well, but it is fairly lightweight for the size of the trailer. So again, good balance between quality and the livability part of it, but also towability. Notice the welds and on the corners there. If you could see, you probably can only see one, maybe two welds in there, but they're all consistent. It's full welds, not spot welded. So a good testimony to the way they put these together. Even have your tank controls inside of here, because this is completely enclosed underbelly, so when you have your furnace on, it all has radiant heat down in here underneath, so protect your tanks. The tanks even have the insulation barrier that puts underneath the tank, help protect the bottom of your holding tanks from freezing up. I like the fact this one has electronic leveling too. This has auto level system, so once you pull into your campsite and get disconnected from your truck, you can just hit auto level. It's going to level itself out. Makes it real easy to get set up. And your hookup, everything's kind of right inside of here too, again out of the weather. You've got a light in here so you can see what's going on if you're doing this at night. Black tank flush is right here, so you have a way to keep your black tank cleaned out. Plug in here for satellite prep, fresh water connection, even has a battery disconnect. Again, I like that. This magnet really makes it nice. I mentioned it has three slide outs. We'll go inside and you'll be able to see the way this thing's laid out. But notice while we're right here too, it does have flush mounted windows. So the frameless flush mounted windows give you a nice clean look. The seals aren't exposed to the weather. That's nice. So you've got, you know, if it's even us, most people are going to probably have their fifth wheel or their RV of some sort out in the weather, so this kind of protects that seal from being exposed to the weather a lot. Let's take a walk back around to the other side. want to stop here for just a second. You can see the nice awning. It's got a great patio awning that's electric, so this is going to come out with just the push of a button. We'll see the controls once we go inside. Outside speakers makes it nice. You can sit out here on the patio, listen to some music at night. This is a Western Edition model, so it's made in Pendleton, Oregon. I mentioned it's a 283RE is the model, the RET, the Western Edition. That's what the WE stands for. I'd like to point out too, it is an all-season unit, so these are actually 0 degree rated. So Cougar has an outside company, I believe it's Dometic, that tests these for them. They put them in 0 degree conditions for up to 72 hours to make sure that the holding tanks and your water lines don't freeze up under those conditions. So they meet that degree of rating. And so again, we consider these like an all-season unit. It's half ton, part of the half ton series too, which makes it nice. I like these new steps. They've gone away from the steel steps and gone to an aluminum, a little bit lighter, easy to work, but in and out. But boy, they're sure nice and sturdy. You come into the coach, you can see right away you got a nice little kitchen area with an 8 cubic foot two-door refrigerator, freezer separate from the refrigeration unit. This is gas and electric, so it'll operate off of either. If you're plugged in somewhere, you can run it off the electric element, or if you dry camp, you can use the propane section. Lots of storage. Some of it's kind of high there, but you've got places where you can put stuff that maybe you don't use all the time. Great amount of storage in here too. It's going to come with a microwave and a regular gas oven, the larger of the two types of ovens they normally put in here. This is a 22 inch as opposed to the 17 inch. Notice the nice stainless steel front. Three burner stovetop. Nice sink cover. Covers two stainless steel sinks, so you have a nice residential look. Nice countertops. We've gone to a little bit more residential type of faucet on these with the sprayer. Nice deep cabinet down here. Great place to put maybe your garbage can. Another drawer here. See, they do have metal glides to add stability. If you come around the outside, over around here on the other side of the kitchen, you can see it's got two nice deep cabinets down, or drawers down here also that are full extension. And another access to that storage compartment up on top. Two really nice recliners in this slide out on the driver's side of the coach. Notice you've got good windows. All of these windows are going to open up too, so you can actually open these windows up, get some air flowing through here. They give you cabinets, so you've got storage that you can utilize above the chairs here in your slide out with a nice light. Notice they're pretty deep slides too, so it adds quite a bit of floor space. This one really opens up nice because you do have opposing slides. So the rear has also windows, let in some light, but you're also designed with the idea that you can watch your TV from back here on pretty much any area in this coach. Back in here, you'll be able to see the TV. It does pull out and swivel also. It's cinched in right now, just that's kind of in the travel mode. Again, they utilize the space really well. Lots of cupboards, lots of lights, lots of plug-ins. And this one is equipped with an electric fireplace also. So that's going to put out, that's not just a fireplace, it's also a furnace, so it's going to put out heat. It's a regular heater, electric element. So you can use that to really heat this whole little area in here. You could probably heat the downstairs part of your coach with just that. You have a propane furnace is your primary heat source, which is ducted, and we talked about that. So when that furnace is on, you've got radiant heat all in that under belly of your fifth wheel to keep everything nice and warm and keep them from freezing up. Has a all fully ducted air conditioning system in it also. So heating and air conditioning is all ducted. Another slide out over on the patio, or the patio side of the fifth wheel. Notice this one's a little bit longer, but it's also a deep slide, so adding more livable space. Has a trifold sleeper sofa. This makes into a bed. So does the dinette. And the table you can actually move around. So this is something you could take outside if you were out somewhere where you maybe wanted to move it around, or even use it outside. And you have storage underneath the dinette here also. Coming out into the upstairs area where you have your bedroom, I like the fact they've put your controls in really one central location. Easy to access because it's right inside the door. You can check your tank levels from right here. A lot of your lighting is controls are right here. Hot water heater, water pump, slide out controls are right here. Also the awning, I mentioned that's electric. You can control your awning from in here too. Run the in and out, runs right off your batteries. This is a side aisle coach, which basically means you've got a private bath. You've got access into your bathroom here with your sink, shower, and the toilet are all in one. A lot of people like that. Gives you a little more privacy. Nice skylight there to let in some natural light. Also have access into the bathroom area from the bedroom. This is a porcelain toilet bowl also. But I like the fact that it's got a nice little sliding door over here. And then this is your third slide out up in here. This is a wardrobe slide with you can access from inside the bathroom and in the bedroom here. So you've got additional closet space. They do give you some more closet space over here and storage up above the bed also. Notice you do have a light and a nightstand over on the side of the bed there with more drawers. I like the fact that you do have a little headboard here that has a light, and then in on both sides you probably maybe can't see that. Well, actually on this side you have a 110 outlet, then over here you have a charging station, so you can plug in maybe your phone if you want to charge up your phone. You've got a way that you can do that. This queen size bed up front here with storage underneath. Great place to throw incidentals down in there. Like I mentioned before, you know, maybe you're looking for something that's big enough to be comfortable in, so but not so big that it's hard to get around. The way this thing's laid out, it give you plenty of livable space. If you're going to do some extended travel, this could be a good choice, and yet you can get it in probably some of your favorite spots. You don't have to worry about some place to be able to put it. So good balance between livability and towability. Give me a call if you would. If you have other questions, please give me a call. It's Jim Beckler, and you can reach me at 541-510-1017. Thanks for your time.